We're fine, everybody. We're fine. We're fine. We're fine. We're fine. We're fine. Guys, guess what? This back to school season. You know about this. Let HelloFresh handle dinner. Their quick and easy meals take the stress out of mealtime, even on hectic weeknights. Get 65% off plus free shipping with code VALLEYCAST65. Woo! At HelloFresh.com/VALLEYCAST65. That's right. It's different this time. Go to HelloFresh.com/ValleyCast65 and use code ValleyCast65 for 65% off and free shipping. We're fine.
We're fine.
Don't feel like watching movies, so I'll watch people get them instead. I don't know how it goes. I think it starts with your show.
Elliot, you look like you're in movie Misery. And you've been recently hobbled. And you,
Elliot, were you hobbled? You have to tell us.
Hobbled.
You legally have to tell us if you were hobbled.
Grace came in with a sledgehammer and she smashed my little ankle.
Hobbled is such a horrible word.
It really is.
I got hobbled.
What'd you do this weekend? Well, I got hobbled.
I got hobbled. Again.
And it's something that, like, a lot of people are like, what does that mean? They don't, like, quite it. They don't get it at first. And it's like, it doesn't seem like it's going to be that, like, vicious of a reality. And then you explain what it is, and it's like, dear God.
Dude, that movie Misery is real good.
Mm-hmm.
That's a very good movie.
Kathy Bates, baby.
Kathy Bates and James Caan.
I just watched Thor: Love and Thunder, both of those, the sequel too, and it was the best Marvel movie I've ever seen.
Jesus Christ. I can't put my finger on it.
I think
did you watch Thor Ragnarok?
Yeah, awful piece of shit movie.
We'll be right back.
We'll be right back.
I got a question for you guys. Is the riff? You know what I'm talking about. Is the riff from the song Father Figure racist?
I will be your father figure. Put your tiny hand in mine. I will be your preacher teacher.
The riff.
Oh, not the lyrics. The riff? Oh, because it's got a little bit of an Egyptian flair.
Yeah.
No, it's just inspired.
Okay. So you liked Love and Thunder, huh?
Steve, in our experience, do you think Joe is somebody who should be making the call on what is and isn't racist?
Look
at the track record.
Look, all I'm saying...
Where do we begin?
Is that if our visage is quite like the man white Jesus's visage, I feel like we can do and say whatever we want. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, God.
I hope we do this until we're old, like real old.
We're getting there.
I hope we do it until we're too old. And people are like, they're still doing that.
For those of our audio listeners, Joe has a Halloween decoration up, and it is not October. Excuse me.
It's not October, but it is fall.
It's not fall yet.
You would be surprised by the number of my neighbors that have stuff up. But this is not technically technically it's Halloween decoration.
That's your son.
However, yeah. So much changed in
that's
the
your son's
that
skeleton. You guys put your son's skeleton up as a decoration.
No, this is birthday decorations for Hayden. She loves like Halloween
spooky
and the
stuff
a little bit. Yeah.
Cool.
It went up early, and apparently these are red.
Okay.
Why do
they
you guys
like blood?
They do. Was that the intention? To look kind of spooky?
I think more of an autumnal look is what they were going for.
Mm, nice, nice.
Do you guys think that we should keep the bones of our loved ones in our homes when they die?
No.
You don't think it'd be cool to be like, and this is my skeleton gallery?
I don't like clutter.
All the bones? There's all 206?
Here's a pile of bones. This pile of bones is my family.
What if we...
No, what if you had like a little museum room or something and you could walk in and there's like... First you walk in and there's like taxidermied pets and you're like, whoa, okay. I've seen this. Were these your animals? And then you go, yes, these were our beloved pets. And then you walk a little further and then there's like a skeleton, like a human skeleton. And then you're like, whoa. And then you just see like a row of like well put together, well hung skeletons. Big dick.
You want a few well-hung skeletons.
Yeah, I just want a few. I just want the skeletons of my well-hung relatives.
Only the well-hung. How about I'll give you a little twist on it, a twist pitch. Let me pitch the twist.
Okay. Okay. I love a twist.
What if it's just a little less like visually creepy and we hide them in functional attributes within our abodes? So it's like, hey, you got a new couch. Like, yeah. The frame is my dad's bone.
Yeah. Yeah. Or like a couple of these forks are different than the rest of the forks.
Why is that?
Well, I whittled down some of the tibia.
This bowl is beautiful. What is this bowl? It's so smooth. It feels like a weird... What is this, ceramic?
Well,
no, that's
that?
Actually... That's my ex-wife's... skull.
Cousin. Yeah.
Yeah, see what you did there in the bathroom, Steve. Just use the plunger. It's actually it looks a little different.
Why does this plunger look like an arm?
I mean, you know that my well hung grandpa just died.
But you guys have seen those funerals where like they put the person's body, they prop the body up in like a, like going like this, like.
Yeah, that's a, yeah.
Wait, it's more like this.
Yeah, they keep the eyes open.
What was that? That was like a news story a while back, right, where they didn't know that was going to happen, and they showed up, and there was in the hotel room.
No, there
what
was a...
that. They set up the body in the hotel room. And
wait! There's a couple.
And they were traumatized.
I forgot about that one. Yeah. That one's so crazy. That one's so crazy.
What was that one?
It was hold on. Let's paraphrase.
Still there.
Let's paraphrase. Let's try to paraphrase.
Yeah, try to remember.
Try to remember, and then we'll look it up. Basically, it's like this couple's son died or something, and their family like planned for them to like go on like a vacation or something. To like,
yeah, this is going great.
To get them to like go, like get away from, you know, have a getaway, you know, go on a little vacation. Your son died, go on vacation, and then didn't they surprise them by putting the body in their hotel room or something?
I feel like it wasn't quite the body.
Oh, no, no.
Like a picture.
No. Nope.
Oh, I know what it is.
You remember?
Yeah. I remember.
Okay, now you remember. Their son died. And then the hotel, like, I guess the family called the hotel. The relatives called the hotel and told them what their son, like things their son loved and stuff.
Give some context, yeah.
And like, you know, like Doritos and Mountain Dew and video games and stuff.
Just
and so they
a lot of porno, just porn. So they, porn.
So while the couple was out, they went into their room and they made like a, fake. Yeah. Body of like a person, of like a teenager in their bed out of like hotel towels and shit,
and I think like soda cans.
And then they put soda cans and like. How do we find this? Did you
before
find it?
You kept talking,
let me look for it. Ellie, you tell Joe and let me find it.
Before you guys kept like giving details, like halfway through the story, I was like, okay, this was well intentioned. They just made a mistake.
It was totally well intentioned.
But then no, it was not.
Apparently it's in that culture thing that you do.
Oh, okay.
And so they
are you sure?
They were being, that's what I heard that the hotel, at least their defense was.
The thing that they do at this special hotel is
completely wrong.
In Toledo.
Apparently, I remember it being an actual dead child.
This hotel in Kansas City.
Yeah.
They'll make a vague version of your loved one.
Whoa.
Oh, okay, hold on. Hotel room
leaves.
Leaves. Like.
This could go so many ways.
I know, and I don't want to. And I don't want to find.
Are you putting this into an AI art generator?
I don't. okay, hold on. Hotel room leaves. Oh, how about memorial to dead?
Yeah.
Family.
That is not the title that Gawker would have used.
Hotel leaves effigy of couple's dead son on bed in horrifying tribute.
There it is.
Oh. I have truly never seen anything like it, friend says in response to dummy body with tears on face and beer in hand.
Beer in hand, that was the thing.
It wasn't even face. His favorite beer.
Oh, fuck man. It. Well, let me see the picture because I don't have the law. Like, I didn't sign up for their bullshit.
No, that's the worst.
Try incognito tab. That sometimes works.
Really?
Yeah, sometimes.
Wait. How about that? Oh, okay. Here we go. Oh, man. Oh,
you put yourself
man.
In the right mindset. You're walking in, you're on vacation. Yeah. Like, you're trying to take, you don't want to forget
so
your
nice
reason.
To get away.
Exactly. It's like, you're not going to ever forget, but you are taking a reprieve from thinking about it for 5 minutes. Just 5 minutes. Like, let's remember the good times. This was fun. Zip lining was great, honey. Let's go back to the hotel room. Let's get a
They're
little
connecting.
Crazy. We're going to open up the mini bar. We're just going to let it go this weekend. And then, cue picture. Oh my god.
We miss you. Why is there tears?
The balloons are so strange.
Why are there tears?
Look how cool he is though. He's got sunglasses on.
He looks like
the
he's just
hands.
Happy birthday, Alexander.
Oh
those gloves, this hand right
wait,
here.
Wait. Did they put a pre bite in the cake to make?
I
it
don't
look
know.
Like
it really does look like something's going on with the cake there.
Oh, they maybe did. Oh man.
Oh boy. It looks like the "We Miss You, Alex" was drawn in blood.
It was used with pieces of tongue.
Initial, like your brain doesn't register. Your brain first registers that there's a person laying on your bed with a cake, not that it's a fake person or that it says happy
birthday.
Yeah,
it's like this is someone
you
sleeping
would,
in my
first absolutely terrify you.
Yeah, you'd be terrified. Who the fuck is that? Who's in my room?
Elliot, I want you to break down some grammar for me. Let's get grammatical for a second. There's a space between birth and day. And I'm wondering if that kind of changes the meaning of everything just a little bit.
I think there's a lot of things that had meanings changed after this event.
What's up with the the like leaves? Like the little pieces of like these palm
just
leaves.
Make it romantic.
Is that are the palm leaves are what they made these letters out of, I think.
Yeah.
Oh, man, interesting.
Yeah. Dude, who thought this was a good idea?
It's one of those things that, you know, it just thanks for that memory. Thanks for that tour down.
The one I was thinking of was there was like a celebration of some rapper who died. and they all went to this club, and it was like a private event, and they all went to this club.
Yeah, but he was like up in his coffin.
Not even in a coffin. They just had him up there. Had him up there, like, leaning up against the wall. And people were like, this was weird. It was like we were in the club, and he was just up there, like, dead.
So if you're allowed to do that, okay, I have a question for you guys. And a request. A request. If in my will I said I would like, before I'm cremated, my buddies Steve and Elliot to Weekend at Bernie's me for 2 days.
Oh, God. And do what? Like, take just you
take
you
out,
to the
man.
Beach?
Yeah. Let me be your wingman.
What did they do with him in the movie? They took him to the beach.
They went everywhere. I think they even, like, puppeteered him a little bit.
Mm-hmm. Remember that scene where they're like, this guy's dead. What do we do? And the friend goes, let's take him to the beach.
Looks like we got to get laid.
we got to get laid, so let's take him to the beach.
To answer your question, Joe, yeah, that's fine. I don't care.
I love it. Great. Perfect. And then make me into a couch.
Joe, I have reservations. Yeah. And is there any way that we can switch those reservations to a different day? Thanks, man.
Do you remember what I would consider probably, we covered a lot of creepy stories at SourceFed, but this reminds me of one of the creepiest. Do you know which one I'm alluding to?
No.
I don't think I can. How about before you even tell us, Elliot, do you even have an idea in your head of, like, one creepy SourceFed story?
I think I forgot most SourceFed stories the moment they were out of my little
mouth. It is
my dumb little mouth.
I remember a few of them.
I think the job did fuck our brains a little bit.
For sure it did.
Like, yeah. The fact that we had to, like, ingest sometimes very complex stories and arguments
and simplify them,
and then just go to the next story about a dinosaur that might have existed.
And then here's a feeling good with Joe with all this good shit. And then there's like, no, we got three car accidents that happen at the same time.
The one that I'm talking
about. Put a hot girl in the thumb.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Put a hot cop in the thumbnail.
Sad hot girl.
Every dinosaur story had a hot cop in it.
She's like arresting the cop. arresting the dinosaur.
The one that comes to mind is the story of, it was like a 6-year-old kid that died, and then they were at the funeral, and the motherfucker sat up in the coffin and was like, can I have a glass of water? And they got him a glass of water, and then he died again.
What? I don't remember that.
Yeah.
Can we watch that SourceFed story?
And then there's another one that I did where we talked
that
about
would
some
be more traumatic.
Some dude that got like.
That would be more traumatic than just the story itself.
The other,
he
like
said words.
Yeah, he asked for a glass of water and he laid down and died again. It was crazy.
Let's see. There's funeral strippers banned in China.
Okay, you'll get there.
Woman surprises husband at her own funeral.
Oh, man.
The study episode.
I think it might have been one of those.
Boy asks for water at funeral.
Boom!
Kevin Santos, Brazilian boy pronounced dead, briefly resurrected to ask for water. A 2-year-old toddler who's pronounced dead sat up in his coffin during his funeral and asked his father for a drink of water before laying lifeless in the coffin once again, according to Brazilian news sources.
What the fuck?
Yeah.
Wait.
The other crazy one that I did that I remember was a story about, like, some dude that had 247 teeth extracted from his head.
Oh.
That was a fun one. Anyways, source fed.
Give me teeth.
What?
Gross.
They were just packed up in there?
Yeah.
I found a Reddit thread about this funeral, and one of the top comments says, thinking it all out in my head, this is the single scariest thing I've ever heard in my entire life.
Just thinking about it.
Yep, it is the single scariest thing I could ever possibly imagine.
And traumatic.
How are you guys doing? What's going on?
Man.
Well, I'm happy to have you back, Joe.
Yeah.
Joe, you've been gone for a bit. You were a sick boy. What's going on? You back?
I am. I'm back. I'm free. It was 2 weeks of freaking isolation. Had my COVID. First time. Daughter brought it home from school. Like I said, It was like a fifth period algebra strain is what we got. Nice. And
I've heard that's going around.
Overall, like symptomatically, not horrible. I had 2 days of like really like achy body. The worst, like being in my, it was like centralized in my ass. You know, like when you get a flu, sometimes your lower back hurts. That's where you get the body pain. Mm-hmm. It started there, but then it like super increased down into my legs. And again, like gravitationally, like was in my asshole. And actually, wow, ass cheeks.
Your
and,
asshole is a real big point of pain for you, Joe.
Nah, it wasn't. I misspoke. It was ass cheeks. But it's like, it was reminiscent of like back in the day when you would go to like do two-a-days in football after a summer of doing nothing.
And you would... we know what you're, Steve, you know what he's talking about.
Yeah, one summer I did one-a-days, and that one held pretty.
Right.
That one did a lot for my body. Yeah,
after I tossed the old pigskin.
That's right.
But yeah, that was it. And then I just sat around waiting for negative tests for fucking ever. It was the worst. But I watched a lot of movies.
What did you watch anything of note?
I caught up on the Harley Quinn animated series, the new season, and it's amazing. I caught up on Rick and Morty. I caught up on Primal. I watched a bunch of older, like, late 90s, early 2000s flicks with Hayden while she was in quarantine with me for a while. So we did, like, Good Will Hunting and Fight Club and a bunch of that other stuff.
Cool.
It was good.
How'd she like Fight Club?
She loved it. She's officially in that that era of I can watch like cool dramas now.
She's finally into
dramas a little bit.
Yeah, she's into cinema.
She's getting into cinema, but it's just too bad that she's an angsty little asshole teenager. And being in quarantine with her, I was going in thinking we would bond a little bit. I've never felt more hated in my life.
Is that because you named her hated Hayden?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Looking back on it was my fault.
Hayden.
Shouldn't have called her Hayden. Why do you think that is? Do you think it's because of the like the Stockholm syndrome kind of thing going on?
Just that age, man. It's like I'm living with a stereotype.
It's
crazy.
Like you've never heard "just leave me alone, dad" more in your life.
She doesn't have to say it. I feel like physically assaulted every time she rolls her eyes at me, which is every time I speak.
And there's nothing you can do about it.
No, I'm trying so hard.
Yeah, you can't do anything. You just got to let it pass, I hear.
Yep.
In my day, if I rolled my eyes at my parents, I was put in the basement for quite a while.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The basement had the smaller TV.
Smaller TV and only the Super Nintendo.
Had one of those 4x3 tube TVs.
Yeah, that's where all the VHS tapes were. You didn't even know how to work those.
But
man,
she had
rolling eyes. That says something now to me that if that happens, it's like it is like a slap in the face. You're like, I don't.
It's the most offensive thing you could do to someone who's being like genuine to you.
It's literally like on questions of like, hey, how are you feeling today? And just like.
Oh God! Like, here we go again.
What do you think? What like? Yeah, you know it's just hormones and weird shit. You know what it is. You felt that way for a little bit, didn't you, Joe? Like you didn't hate your dad, I'm sure, but
I'm sure I was a shit in my own way.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
But yeah, you know, I will say she had a couple like mitigating factors that I think contributed to the attitude, you know, COVID, missing school, doesn't get to be around her friends. She's at that age where the friends are the real family. And she was also like trying to get better against the clock because it was also her birthday and she had birthday plans on Friday. Yeah, and then she had birthday plans on Saturday and they kept being like, sorry, you tested positive this morning. You can't do it. And it was just like, it was like I invented science and disease.
When she comes to you and says, like, Dad, I feel like absolute shit. Do you just roll your eyes and walk away?
Every time now. Yeah. And then I ask her, for money.
Fire fire. Give me money. Why don't you do your job and give me money?
But the good news is she got out like a week earlier than I did, and she's fine too. Like there's no long-term
good
effects. I didn't lose my smell, didn't lose my taste. I think my smell improved.
Right. You have a better sense of smell now?
It's weird. The isolation in the final week started to get to me a little bit though. Like it was just there's only like sitting in a room watching movies by yourself.
I know.
It only goes so far.
It sounds so nice. It sounds nice. It's like, man, I wish I could just lay in bed and watch movies all day. And then you do it and you're like, oh, I feel like hell doing this. Mm-hmm. This isn't good for your body. You can't just do this.
I gained my sanity. I regained my sanity. And when I realized, oh, I just don't need to be around my family. I can go for walks and drives. So I started doing that a lot and went for some really long walks, which was nice. So,
like what kind? Well, how long are we talking here?
Miles, baby. Miles and miles.
Like a couple of hours?
Sometimes, yeah. And then I'd be like, oh, I need a rapid test. So instead of driving to CVS, I would walk to CVS.
That's nice. I like to walk. I really like walking a lot. Yeah. It's nice. It's nice to just go out and it really does clear your mind and make you feel better and shit.
Yeah.
It's weird how that works.
So overall, don't recommend, but I could have had it far worse like many others. And wife didn't get it, and that's the most important.
That's good.
Yeah, totally great.
Very resilient woman you got there, Joe.
She's going to sleep for 7 weeks.
So speaking of isolation and feeling alone, I started watching Alone.
Oh, good.
I'm on board, boys. I just started watching it.
What
Thank
season?
You. And my fucking God, am I hooked.
Isn't
I
it?
I tell you.
This show fucking hooks you, man.
It shouldn't be that good.
It shouldn't be that perfect. Good because it's kind of the same shit over and over again. But you want to see it happen to different people. Somehow it happening to different people is entertaining.
But you know what's so impressive about it? At the end of the day, it's like these super capable survivalists shouldn't be as capable as they are. They shouldn't also be able to run 7 cameras and audio.
I know. I know. I think about that a lot. I think about they probably need to be trained on how to use those.
I think they
get
trained. Yeah. I think they give them like a rundown of how to set everything up.
Yeah, because a lot of the shots look the same, and there are a lot of those establishing shots. So they probably taught them how to like leave the camera far behind them while they go do stuff off in the background, because they have hours of footage of each contestant doing that pretty much.
Sure, but like imagine basic. How annoying it is for them at the same time. Like,
I know.
Like, oh, fuck God. Yeah. If I don't eat a fish today, I'm going to die. But first, I got to set up this camera.
I got to get my lav on. Like, they're definitely miking themselves.
Can't feel my
shit.
Toes, but let me hit record. Dude, with my little frozen nub of a hand.
Lady that's, like, holding the camera right here, and she's like, I think I poisoned myself to death.
Did you see the one where the woman just gets sick to her stomach and she projectile vomits like 8 times in a row into her own fire?
So, inside
of her cabin.
What season is that?
I don't know. I get them all mixed up.
So I think I started on a season where there's the guy who like had a heart attack a bunch of years in the past. And then he felt like he was having another one. And
I think
so
you're on the newest season.
It was like the one. The one before the newest one, I think.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
But it's like the guy was like, I don't want to die out here. I'm having a heart attack. And it's like, you know what I'm talking
about? Oh, but first thing I'm going to put the camera on.
And I did.
They said 6 feet away.
That's the same one with the woman who is like barfing her guts out because she had like weird berries or something.
Also confident, she's like, I can eat these, and then fucking slam cut.
Dude, there was this one woman that was like, these mushrooms are like supposed to be like really nutritious. Like they'll keep you like okay, like you'll be safe and it'll fill you up. It has all the nutrition you need. And she like cooked it and then she took like one little bite of it and she's like, that's the worst thing I've ever put in my mouth.
The subtitles will say,
and I'm on my couch shoving pizza into my mouth. Okay. Oh, you gotta eat it. Oh, damn, dude. My name to eat that shit. Bring, give me another Coke.
Dude, turn the AC down. It gets to the point where you might be in this season or not. I can't remember, but like at one point, this guy is just like, "Well, we're at this point where I've never tried this before, but apparently you can eat wood, so I'm gonna."
Yeah.
I just will see.
Dude, like, you just take off some of this bark, put this little bark under it. You can.
Yeah,
you can eat this,
and then he boils it, and then he drinks it like the broth that he made with wood, and then you're like, that's not gonna that. I've never heard of that. That's not going to go well. And spoiler, it doesn't go well.
I like how the show gets kind of like cheeky, and it goes like it shows this guy going like, "Fuck, I haven't eaten in like 3 days. I'm having like my brain is fucking up my." Like, you start to really fall apart when you, like, yeah. don't eat, and you can see that happening to these, like, really, like, they're head-on straight humans that, like,
yeah.
can live off the land, and you see them losing their minds, and you're like, damn, that's fucking nuts. But I love how they show, like, the show gets cheeky because it shows, like, someone going, like, struggling, like, if I don't eat in like, 6 hours, I'm gonna have to tap out or I'm gonna die. And then it cuts to this other guy, and he's like, all right, well, I'm working on a freeway, right?
I went ahead and made new indoor plumbing, I mean, so I don't have to go outside.
We just built the town hall, and some of us are gonna
start hiring. I killed a bear, and I'm just, oh, I'm stuffed.
I'm hiring staff for my micro pub, my gastro pub.
Yeah.
We serve fusion food. It's great.
One of my favorite things they'll do is they'll be like, it'll be somebody being, I think I can eat this berry. This is this kind of berry. And then the text will pop up on the screen. That's like, that kind of berry looks remarkably like another berry that
that'll
causes
kill
dysentery.
You. I like the guy that was like drinking the stream water, and he's like, oh, it's so good. Fuck, this water's so good. And then the text pops up and it says, sometimes water is contaminated with disease and you could die. And it shows the guy just like, you're like, all right, I get it.
This guy's got a 1 in 7 chance of contracting diphtheria and shitting his brains out.
Dude, it's crazy because like you don't even think about things like what the human body is capable of and how you like need to keep an eye on like the amount of calories you're like using versus the amount of calories you're taking in and yeah. shit. And it's crazy how like this guy like was just looking for food all day and didn't even realize that like he's now 3 miles away from his camp and he couldn't find food. And so he's like, now I gotta go 3 more miles back to my camp where I know I also don't have food. And
thank
just like,
God there's a bunch of trees I can eat on the way.
Dude,
the most impressive part of the whole show, aside from just like general survival, is all the fucking cool different like shelters they build.
Dude, I agree. So cool. It's impressive.
That was what I think originally sold me on the show. When they like they started making, I was like, all right, this is cool. They'll just like survive in a tent. And then it cuts to one and it looks like a full on log cabin.
Yeah.
With, like a swinging door and mm-hmm. like a decoration outside of it. And you're like, wow, that's beyond. That's I couldn't chop the wood down to be able to build that, let alone actually do it. Like,
I also
we're gonna
love
pack it with moss. We're going to pack it with moss with insulates.
Dude,
like,
yeah.
Great. Good for you. Wouldn't have ever.
Yeah,
put a little
mud.
Hole over here for some airflow. I yep. got my heating system over here. I got
yeah.
to make sure.
Right.
It's crazy. It's so cool.
Yeah, they talk about how they're going to like build their fireplace and stuff. And it's like, wow. And then like, this is where the chimney's going to go. It's so crazy. Because, I mean, like, yeah, they all get there and they're all like, this is because like, what is it? You're supposed to be there for as long as you possibly can.
As long as you possibly can. You have to outlast everybody else without knowing
how long they've lasted or whatever.
Exactly.
So someone could still be going while everyone's tapped out, or they'll tell them that everyone tapped out.
Once the last one goes, yeah. then there's two left, one goes, they'll immediately go to the next person after they tapped out and be like, you're the last one.
So if there's two people left, do they tell them that?
No.
Wow.
You have no clue.
So they could be out. What's the long? So you guys have been watching it for a while. I'm like 6 episodes in. What's the longest anyone's?
I looked it up.
Gone?
It's like over 100 days, I think.
Damn.
I think it might be right at 100, maybe a little over, but somebody went. And that's now become like the gold standard where everyone's like, do you have a Juan, what's his name? Juan
87 days. 87 days.
Oh, it is 8. They didn't make it to 100. Okay.
Jesus, yeah. 87 days. So what is that, like almost 3 months? Yeah.
And that's like, you know, they're going through like missing their Christmases and their Thanksgivings and everything. And then it's getting colder and colder and they're starved. It's crazy.
I'm so invested because it's like, the other thing that's really interesting that keeps me coming back too is like the types of people that sign up. Because there's all sorts of different types of people. There's these guys that are like, oh, yeah, man. Like, you think everyone is more than qualified. Like, while you're watching and they explain what their specialties are, you're like, oh, this person's totally going to make it. And then it's like day four they tap out or something, you know? But one of the ones I found super interesting was that there was this, like, Stone Age or, like, Ice Age expert or something, like – that woman that was like, she's like an expert on like the medieval.
I'm an expert on the Ice Age. Yeah. It's gone. So,
ask question. Me anything about the Ice Age right now.
Look around.
It's gone. But there was this person who was like an expert on like medieval, like fucking tools like, and survival.
Yeah, ancient. Prehistoric survival.
Prehistoric survival. And it was like, dude, that person's the most qualified out of anybody, I think. Because it's like they'll be able to like locate roots that'll keep them alive for months or whatever.
It's crazy.
There was one season where they do, I don't think they've done it since then, but they were doing teams of two. So people were together the entire time. Mm-hmm. And spoiler alert on that one, there was like this a bunch of different ages and there were these two brothers who just argued the entire time and would like make fun of each other and kind of hated each other and it was just kind of get off like that kind of thing. They won the whole thing because they didn't do anything except sleep under a tarp and then they got like 500,000 and everyone was like, you guys are just dork. Like,
wait, so they won?
They won the whole thing. Yeah.
Because so, and were they like, what were they eating and stuff?
They would go like fishing and then they'd fight about the fishing and then they'd like hurt each other and then they would like stumble. Like, it was a comedy of errors the whole time. And then they, the people come up to them and like, you won. They're like, oh my God. Oh, wow. They're like Canadian or something. It was great.
Oh, geez, eh?
Oh, wow. No, dude, wow. Okay.
Oh, buddy.
It's an adrenaline high for some of them to the point where they bring, people have done it multiple times. Like, so there's people that were in like the first couple seasons that like didn't win it. One guy didn't win and he comes back, goes to a different location and he wins the whole fucking thing.
Whoa. Like, so they let people come back sometimes.
I'm sure like casting for it isn't easy.
No, it must not be.
Yeah. I do. Because
you probably get
that.
A lot of people that are like, I love money. I can hang out outside.
And then they put them through their testing phase and they just don't pass. Yeah.
Because it's like there's some liability there. I'm sure you're like, you're signing your life away when you do the show. But if it's just some Joe Schmo that is like gonna die, like there's probably like a rating system that they have behind the scenes where they're like, yeah, Steve Zaragoza, he signed up. He's a real funny guy. It's great.
He's
on
an
camera.
Influencer. He's got a bunch of followers. It could be good for the show, probably.
It looks like according to our system, guaranteed death.
Well, we need one of those code on red. The show. Has anybody died on the show?
No, I don't think so. I don't think the show would be going anymore. If that
Do
happened.
You think that the threat? So I'm watching the season where they're like in a grizzly peak or something. There's like grizzly bears everywhere.
Yeah.
Do you guys think that they're in actual danger, or are they in an area where they're like the bears are a bit more docile and not super?
No.
You guys think they're in actual danger?
They're terrified every time a bear.
Well, I know they are, but do you think that's
I think they're in
TV show shit.
No.
You think they're in actual, like they could be mauled and murdered by a bear?
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I think that the odds are I don't think they'd put them in a situation where they are more greater than 50%.
That's what I'm saying.
To get bear maw, but I think it's definitely. I mean, after watching a few of the seasons, I definitely get the impression that no, this is for sure a miserable experience and very dangerous.
Yeah. Well, that's what I'm saying. Like,
especially water stuff, like the being able to fish and like the frozen water, just that they'll like kind of walk out on, and you're like, that's a bad. You could die very quickly. Like, you got to be very careful. And then
it's interesting.
And, like,
have you gotten to a part where they go, they do the medical checks and they actually tap somebody out against their will? Have you seen
that? I haven't seen that.
So that's how you're gonna know how like real and dangerous it is and how emotional it is as well.
Well, I don't think it's not dangerous. I just think that like for instance, just the bear stuff. Like the bear stuff to me seems suspect. Cause it's like all the footage we're seeing is like really good. Like you get like really good night vision footage of bears and stuff, and then you get like this really good footage of the bears like coming around the corner and stuff, and it's like, are these guys like actually like putting themselves in danger just to get the shot of the bear, or are they like using other bear footage maybe?
Yeah, I wonder if they get bear bonus.
That's what I'm saying.
Survivor has like a B team that'll go out and get like the
establishing shots and stuff,
animals, and like little close-ups of the whatever, and I imagine there's a crew that goes around.
There's gotta be
cameras and catches
well
them, but...
that stuff's pretty obvious, like the establishing shot stuff, like the really nice shots of like eagles flying by or like the spider webs and stuff, like that's definitely some B-team shit. But I'm talking about like when they're faced in a moment where they're like oh fuck, a bear, like are you like kind of like Joe, like we were saying, like with when you're sick, are you gonna pull up the phone and go like, I'm dying, but let me get my camera and make sure that you see me dying? And it's like there's a bear right there and I could die. Let me get my camera. Make sure I set it up. Make sure you can see the bear. And it's like really gonna move around a lot to do that.
There's probably B team shit, but I do think. Have you seen? I know what season you're in now. Have you seen the moment where it's one of the females basically feels like she's being tracked by a bear, and it gets like Blair Witch esque, like she's just freaking out on her camera.
Yeah,
I think you'll understand that it's pretty real when you see that part. She's like fucking terrified.
Yeah, just wonder how much of it is.
I just don't think there's time is
dramatized for television. Like I get this
to believe none.
Yeah, I would also choose to believe none. I feel like some probably, but I wouldn't say. I'd say none is probably impossible.
I think that's kind of the appeal too, because they know that they're speaking to, now that it shows getting popular, not so much, but originally it was for the survivalist community, and they can, I think, sniff out.
I think you're right. I think you're right. Yeah. If anybody could. Dude, we were laughing because there was this part where the fucking guy who tapped out, who was like having a heart attack, like I felt like, man, that guy was probably just like having a panic attack, and like a panic attack can feel like a heart attack, apparently, or can feel like you're about to have a heart attack. And the guy was like, you know, he built this like badass shelter, but then he like didn't have enough energy or strength to get food, and then he just like didn't spend time focusing on getting food first. He focused on building the shelter, and then like he failed, and then they did like an interview with him. You seen those where they like interview them after they tap out? And they get like past participants to like interview them. And those people are like, so what were you thinking when you didn't like fucking like get food first, you idiot? Like more or less, they're totally mocking them. Like,
hey, Hank, actually, do you mind if I call you Heart Attack Hank? Heart Attack Hank.
Well, that's what we call you.
You made like a really big fucking mistake. Like, even signing up. Why'd you do that?
Right. Why'd you sign up if you're like, how about this? I got a question. Why'd you sign up if you had a heart attack like 6 months ago? Why did they even let you do the show?
Does your family not care about you? Anyway, here's a cracker.
Yeah. But I love that they're just like, there's just so many moments like that where the show is just going like, man, fuck you for not making it.
And yeah, the flip side of it, not looking at the people who lasted the longest, but looking at the people who went home the soonest is really, really fun. On the team's season, their brothers, like, they dropped them in two different locations, each member of the team, and they had to find each other.
Oh.
And they had to, like, you know, figure out where they were going to go. And I think the guy was there for about 2 hours. Trips when he's going through the thing, hurts his ankle. Then they have to come pick him up in a helicopter. And then it cuts to the other brother, and he's like, oh no, the helicopter's coming. I hope my brother's okay. And then they land, and they're like, he's just hurt his ankle a little bit. And you can just see like the, well, I'm glad my brother's okay.
Motherfucker.
I'm glad that you...
Glad you're not you're dead.
I'm disappointed, but I'm glad my brother is fine.
Because it's just a sprained ankle. Got there.
Every action on that show is filled with way too much drama. Somebody starts like, hey, I need to eat, but I'm going to make it a little easier on myself, a little bit more convenient. I'm going to whittle a spoon. And as soon as they start whittling, I'm like, don't cut yourself.
You're going to cut yourself.
Don't cut yourself.
Easy.
Yeah. Don't cut yourself.
Or the guy that was like building.
You can tell the rhythm of the show. They'll do the classic cutaway right before the moment.
They'll be like, yeah, I found some mushrooms. All right, yeah, I think I'm gonna be able to eat these. And then he goes, uh-oh. And then it goes, dun 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 dun.
And uh-oh is the best line in the show.
Yeah, yeah. And they're like, fuck it, that's the line we're going to commercial on. People, because like, I think that the idea is that like, if this is airing on TV, you want to make sure they're not going to change the fucking channel the second they have a chance to change the channel.
Oh,
so if they can, if you could give them a little something that'll make them not want to change the channel because they don't want to miss when it comes back, like that's the thought. So it's like they're constantly searching for those moments, and they're so stupid because it'll cut back. It'll go dun, 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 dun. And they go like, all right, I found some mushrooms. Uh-oh. Oh, yeah, no, never mind. This is good.
Okay. These are rocks.
I love it. Reality TV is so funny because you know they're like doing those tricks to like keep people watching and stuff. But it's interesting enough that they don't really need to do it, I don't think.
We discovered Youth Bake Off, Children's Bake Off.
Oh, yeah.
Bake Off, but with children. Yeah. And that's a really fun. We blew through that because that, unlike regular Bake Off, is just the funniest kids screwing up as much as possible, dropping everything, ruining everything, crying and being generally hilarious. And I was like, this is a perfect.
Are they being rough on them? Are they being rough on them?
Not really. They're so sweet to them, but the kid, you know, they're kids.
And they're hours are insane because it's reality television. There's no union, so they're actually working for 17 hours a day.
Yeah, yeah. They go out looking a lot older.
They get to eat all the baked goods they want, though.
Anyway.
In theory, I like this because I've only ever seen clips and memes or whatever. But I want to see like the Gordon Ramsay. Like yelling at kids shows. You ever seen those? Yeah. Have you watched those?
I think there is a Gordon Ramsay, like he did a baking show with kids thing. And if I remember correctly, at least from the clips I saw, he was very sweet.
Yeah, yeah, like, for the most part. But every once in a while you get those clips where he like goes like, you stupid shit! That's not how you make creme brulee. And he backhands this little girl.
Just like over his knee.
You don't get to walk anymore. All right. Anyway, Joe, it's good to have you back, man. I hope we can do one of these pod streams again because those are really fun and it's fun to get the audience reaction.
Let's do pod stream and let's do an in-person now that I'm healthy.
Yeah, dude, why not? I miss doing that.
That room is still set up at your place, right?
Absolutely. It's still set up. It's covered. There's boxes and shit all stuffed in there, but I'll take care of that.
As well as the remains of some of Steve's old dead relatives.
My relatives' bones are in there. I'm setting them up. But I'd love to end us with a would you rather, and then if you guys want to plug some stuff or talk about anything.
Hell yeah. Let's do it. Yeah,
this is me now. Ever since COVID, I only do wacky voices. So,
damn, Joe,
that's a pretty funny voice. Joe.
I like that. I do wacky voices.
Whoa,
though, guys.
Who is this guy?
I like that. I like that, Joe.
I really
that's,
like that. Voice,
it's a logical move for you.
How about this one? Do you like this one?
This is crazy.
That's great.
I'm wacky.
Why were you hiding this?
It just came out, man. It's like sometimes you know when like people hit their heads and they wake up and they're like concert pianists.
Yeah,
I got COVID, and now I do wacky voice.
Can't stop.
Now you just do wacky voices.
Disease.
Wow. Yeah.
All
he
right.
Understands, you know, quantum mechanics now too, but he doesn't. That's not fun for the podcast.
No, it won't, and it won't be. Yeah. All right, let me see. I'm trying to find a quick one. A lot of these are real.
Well, what if we did a podcast called Wacky Quantum Mechanics, and I just do wacky voices while you try to explain quantum mechanics?
I love it.
Okay.
I mean, that's the kind of gold that people have come to expect from this institution.
Dude, this is great. This would you rather comes with a randomizer if you choose the alternative that will randomize this particular result for you, which is really cool. And the question is, would you rather have $10 billion?
Yes.
Or a random superpower?
$10 billion.
$10 billion.
Okay, but do you want to see what superpower you would have gotten if you said yes?
Yes.
Sure.
Okay.
I would love that.
He's doing it again.
Okay.
Joe, if you had chosen to get a random superpower instead of $10 billion? $10 billion.
Don't be a $20 billion superpower. Don't
you
be
get
a
the power to possess great skill in anything. You have enhanced skills. Also,
that would have been fun.
Also called advanced augmented height.
$10 billion fun.
I think you could, because you could have turned that into money, don't you think?
Some would say I've already got an advanced skill.
Yeah.
That's going to make you a lot of money.
And voices!
I love it. I love the voices, Joe. It's a new.
What would you have done, Steve?
Well, $10 billion or a superpower. I'll take the superpower. Let's see what I get. True illusion. The power to manipulate illusions and make them real.
Ooh, you're kind of like Wanda.
Subpower of psycho warping, perfect version of psychosomatic illusion. Cool.
Also called. I'm still having a lot of fun with my $10 billion. I've saved a lot of people. I think I ended hunger.
Yeah, because what happens is people go, oh, well, you can use this to get money. But that's just using up time when if you just take the money, you have the money. And then you can use your time however you want rather than going, how do I turn this superpower into money?
But what if someone came to you, Elliot, and said, would you rather have $10 billion or the power to make illusions real?
$10
billion. $10
billion.
Mm.
I'd take the illusion.
I think $10 billion is too much. It's too high of a number. It's too compelling. If you did like $1 million, that's a little different. $1 million, I could see the superpower. $10 billion is an unfathomable amount of money.
Yeah, somebody will do that like, here's a pile of $1 million, and then they're like, but this is a pile of $10 billion.
Yeah.
And you're like, everybody on Earth was crushed under it. So
yeah.
Yeah.
There's no bank in the world that can hold this money. Elliot, if you had chosen random superpower, you would have gotten Bell attacks, the ability to release / use bells to various attacks.
Whoa.
So you would have bell manipulation.
Bell manipulation.
Bell, also called bell projection. My uncle had that.
Okay, all right. One more. Let's do a little game.
Wait. The user can release / use bells to the attacks. To attacks of various shapes and intensities, either. Yeah, it's literally just using bells as a,
literal bells?
Like bells. Yeah, literal bells.
Dude, Christmas season for
like,
me is crazy.
Yeah, like you could have the Taco Bell.
All right.
Like jingle bells.
We all just fell into a vat of goop and we're all about to get new superpowers. Steve, you're going to randomize all three of us one more time.
Okay.
And we're going to figure out the hierarchy of our team.
Okay. So then we're going to be a team.
We'll shoot that while in the vat.
Who's the leader?
Well, we just came out. We just came out of the vat.
We came out. I see.
And now we're going to figure out the hierarchy of the team based off of our superpowers.
We just came out. Yeah. We just came out of the vat. We're all like, what the fuck? And then this like Nick Fury guy comes in and goes,
hey, guys, motherfuckers.
It's time to start a team.
Yeah.
All right, so
you guys have to choose who's the leader of your team. Yeah,
what is your super? And we're gonna see how effective our team will be too. So Steve,
okay, here we go.
What do you got? Oh, you're morphing.
I have the power to. I have demonic solidification.
What does that mean?
The power to solidify demonic power into a tangible form.
So you can like make orcs and shit.
The user can solidify or give solid-like properties to demonic forces, with the level of solidity going from loose jelly to metal-like hardness or beyond. So they're demonic constructs.
So you can make
demons.
Cool. You can make a
sounds like we're
demon?
A bad guy team.
So far.
Okay, who's
you
next?
You might be our anti-hero, but yeah. your arc is going to bring you all the way full circle in the end. Don't worry.
Yeah. Basically, I'd eventually get this like really cool black suit, and I'd have like long black hair and like a big top hat, and I'd have these two demon babes with me all the time that were like super badass fighters. And they
one's liquid, one's metal.
Yeah.
What's your
one looks like Jell-O.
What's your name?
The Demonizer.
That's pretty good.
The Demon Miser. You're kind of cranky.
Yeah.
Demon Lindelof.
Oh, crap, it's Matt Demon.
Matt Demon. My name's Matt.
Matt
my name's Demon. Matt Demon. All right, who's next? Who's next?
Oh gosh, I just came out of the vat. What? Oh, something feels different.
Oh shit, Joe, you have absolute hearing—the power to hear everything that happens, no matter how far and no matter the conditions.
Have fun with that, Joe.
User is not limited to the average range of enhanced hearing. They can hear everything that goes on in the world or the entire galaxy or even the entire universe. They can do more than just hear everything that goes on. They can even hear the thoughts of anyone and everyone, as well as being able to bypass time itself and hear the past and future.
Okay, I'll be over here in reconnaissance. Fuck.
The silent guy. He never talks.
To, shave your head, Joe, and put you in a wheelchair because you're going to have to be a professor.
Dude, you would totally be the leader because this is like a Professor X thing.
It doesn't. Unless mine is $10 billion, I think you win this one,
Joe. Oh, check this out. Most importantly, they can filter out auditory information to the most perfect precision as much as they want. So they are not necessarily forced to hear everything all at once if they can't handle the input.
Well,
so you can choose.
Let me tune everything out here really quick. Okay. Oh, there it is. Steve.
Yeah.
Sorry. Matt Demon.
Yes.
Your parents are totally boning right now.
What? Stop. Yeah, why do you always really do this? Why do you always do this?
I just
why
want you to know. It's love, dude.
You never tell me good job.
Love.
You never tell me great work making those demons. You always just tell me when my parents are boning.
Look.
Guys, can we please just tell me what my superpower is? Please, I've been waiting here for 20 minutes.
Sorry,
Elliot. You guys are you're listening to thoughts, Joe, and Steve, you're doing something that I don't think any of us fully understand what it means.
I make demons. I can't make it any more simple than that. Okay, Elliot, you have superior machine physiology. Which
are
is
you
the
a robot?
It's the power to use the abilities of a machine that possesses powers.
Okay. All right.
Okay, so the user is.
These written by AI? These were written by AI.
This is from the Superpower Wikipedia. And these are the capabilities. The user either is or can become an empowered machine, which can either be robots, artificial intelligence, cyborgs, androids, etc. Depending on their power sets, they can rival the most powerful threats in combat, and their technological AIs can also possibly be more superior to modern ones due to being proficiently built. Some others could be immune or resistant to weaknesses associated with machines. Super machines can be divided into two separate categories, rational and irrational.
Stop making irrational machines, Elliot.
Yeah, idiot.
Sorry, I guess I'm just a wacky guy.
Oh, wait.
I was trying to show voices.
What's your name?
Yeah.
Oh, it's, yeah, this seems like one of the more unoriginal ones.
Superior machine physiology. So you're basically a robot.
I think I'm Machine Gun Kellyet.
Machine Gun Kellyet.
And ladies and gentlemen, I am the team leader, and my name is the Harlem Lobetrotters.
Ooh, very nice. Anyway, let's go solve some crimes.
Are you sure it's not Paul here?
You just drop a... Was that a Paul Scheer reference?
Yeah.
Dude, we're just an evil... We're a super villain team.
I think we are a bad guy team.
Yeah.
Because you're like a fucking robot. You're like a fucking robot. Joe can hear. Well, Joe, you being able to hear everything is fucking cool. Because you can hear like our bad guys plotting their plans.
Good guys.
Or the good guys.
Yeah,
so you guys want to be bad guys? It's because of my demon thing, huh?
Yeah, kind of like set the
tone. Can't be good guys if we're doing demon stuff.
Yeah, I mean like a robot and a demon and then a guy who... I mean, you'll look the same, Joe, but that's even better.
I just want to change the feeling, just change the overall feelings surrounding demons.
Okay, yeah, let's be good then.
Let's get some PR on making demons not so scary.
Look, at the end of the day, history is written by the winners. So if we start evil, we can go down in the annals of history as if we're good.
We can be anti-heroes. We can be like the Suicide Squad.
Mm-hmm.
What are we? Some kind of suicide?
Wait, what's our team called?
SourceFit.
The Valley Folk.
I was gonna say, the Vatty Folk. Because we came from a bat.
The mutant folk.
Fell in a bat.
The evil folk. All right. Well, guys, thank you so much for listening to the show. Thank you to the patrons. Thank you to our sponsors. Thank you to the casual listeners. Joe, welcome back.
Thank you, sir.
And nice not having Kevin here for a second.
Yeah, right? It's like, shut up for a second, you little twerp.
Mm-hmm.
Twerp is such a mean word.
Yeah, because it implies weakness.
Yeah, if Kevin was on our team, he'd be called Wyatt Twerp.
Wait, let's get Kevin's power. Hang on. Let's see. What's Kevin's power?
Please be a shitty cowboy. Please be a shitty cowboy.
Damaging field projections. Did you say shitty cowboy? What the
shitty cowboy power.
Damaging field projection. The power to project a field that damages anything inside of it.
Like a wheat field.
Whoa.
Or
we should
corn.
Dude, we should call him Hot Box.
Like a field of cows. Like a cowboy.
Let's call him Hot Box, or we'll call him Dutch Oven.
Yeah. Von Dutch Oven.
It can create a generate a field that causes physical damage and wounds anything inside of it. Yeah, we're villains.
Yeah, for sure.
All right, well, thank you so much. Oh, what if we called him Force Field? That's like too real, huh? That's too good.
I'm sticking with Wyatt Twerp.
I'm Wyatt Twerp.
Wait, why do you call him Wyatt Twerp?
Because I can create a field that damages anything inside of it. Oh, okay.
Also, why are you dressed like a fucking 1950s cowboy? What is the cowboy thing? I don't get it. Are you from Texas? No, I'm from San Diego. Our team leader just wanted me to be a fucking cowboy for some reason.
Look, we bought the costume. It's what we had. So you're
we had the costume. You bought it in anticipation for someone being a cowboy. Some kind.
Look, it was December 7th. There was this huge Spirit Halloween sale. I like to stock up. I like to stock up after.
Let me see if there even is a cowboy. No, there isn't. a super. What's your superpower? I'm a cowboy.
Every group's got to have one.
Do you ride on a steel horse? All right, guys.
Okay. Bye.
Thank you for listening, Elliot. Bye. Hey, wait a minute. We can't leave without congratulating Elliot.
Oh, yeah, dude, congrats.
Dude, we didn't even, I can't believe we forgot about this.
It's okay.
You did it.
I was dropping
that's why he can't. Yeah, that's why he can't sit up. The weight of his accomplishments is holding him down.
Yeah. Well,
it's just my brain is so big.
It's so big. You got to lay it back on the.
yeah. You guys don't have to call me Master Elliot, but it wouldn't be correct. It wouldn't be incorrect if you did.
Master Elliot.
That's not how it works. No, nobody's called.
I'm pretty sure that's how it works.
Wait, we can't. Wait, what about Doctor Elliot? We can't call you Doctor.
No,
Elliot?
He's not a doctor yet. No, not yet.
Can we call you a doctor someday? Is that the goal?
I will let you know the moment.
Wait, is it doctor or professor? Would you prefer doctor or professor?
Well, doctor. Doctor, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it'll be. Thank you, guys. Doctors are a very nice load off. Yeah. Doctors are cooler.
Doctors are cooler, yeah.
Well, a professor is a job. Maybe one day I'll be a professor.
Yeah.
That'd be cool.
A lot of doctors become professors.
A lot of them do.
Sounds like
Elliot, congratulations, man. That's not easy, dude.
Thanks, guys. It was very. It's a nice break. This is the longest break I have, so it's like a 2 or 3 week break, which is very nice. So
does it feel worth it? Does it feel worth it? Mm-hmm. All that work. That's good.
Yeah, it was very scary there at the end, but it was very worth it. So yeah, thanks.
Do you think back on? Do you look back on all of your work and think of like, man, I can't believe I'm here now, or are you like, this makes sense? This is
You kind of. The one experience I've had is looking back is going, whoa, I really, you can tell the difference in, because we had to go through and like our original classes to be able to do all the exams and stuff to summarize everything. And I was like, oh man, I really had no idea what I was talking about at all. And it was so terrible. And
wow.
Way better. So that's nice.
That's good.
And
yeah,
from
it's
a
crazy,
from a comedian perspective.
Yeah.
How
and
do
a
you...
lot of the stuff is about, I'll do comedy and that kind of thing. The only time I got a necessarily bad grade, which wasn't really that bad, was when I did too much comedy, but I could talk about it for the most part.
Couldn't help it. But yeah. You gotta put anyway. Levity in there, right? Like
give a little jokey jokes, but yeah, it's all very fun. So now I got one more year of classes and then 2 years of dissertation writing, and then I'll be done.
And then what happens after all of that? What can we call you then?
Then it's doctor. Then I'll, assuming I get it, then I'll be the most annoying person. I'll be
He's
even
gonna
more
immediately
annoying.
Immediately change his Twitter.
Oh, dude, yeah. Every piece of
Dr.
mail.
Dr. Elliot Morgan.
Anytime anybody says, well, it's doctor.
Can I have a number two with a Coke, please? I don't have an apple pie.
Yes.
And also call me doctor.
Yeah, a caramel macchiato for Dr. Elliot.
Thank you. Yeah, that's me. That is me. Thank you. Thanks. Yeah.
That's great, man. Well, congratulations, Elliot. That's no small feat, dude. I'm proud of you.
Thank you, guys. Thank you very much to everybody. And thank you for listening, folks, to this episode of the Valleycast. And if you want to congratulate me, you can do it at HelloFresh.com/Valleycast65.
Yeah, in lieu of flowers, please get...
In lieu of flowers.
HelloFresh from the Valley folk. All right, guys, thanks for listening. We'll catch you next time on the Valleycast. Bye!
Bye!